Boy, is it ever Wednesday. Hi, I'm Duke of the Bump, and this is Let's Play Popful Male Redux, episode number 11. We had a big episode last time. We met a beardless dwarf, and we have to bribe this crazy man with gold.
Well, I'll tell you, that plan to get past the guards is starting to come back to me. But you know, 4 gold bars just might speed my memory up.
4 gold doubloons. Yeah, we have to bribe that crazy man with gold to figure out what the game wants us to do next. And last time I alluded to knowing pretty much exactly what I have to do. We can't go that way. That's the way that's blocked by the guards. So yeah, basically all we have to do is go back to where those two mummies that dropped the gold bullion were, and we have to kill one of them, since I already have 3 gold bars and we only need 4. But we'll get an extra one out of it, so that'll give us a little extra spending money. So yeah, sorry about the lateness of this video. It's been a hell of a week. For various reasons. One of which being that I fell into the hole that is this game on the Nintendo 3DS. Which stands for 3 dual screen, called Animal Crossing New Leaf. And it's a hell of a game. If you've been following my blog, which you should, dukeofthebum.tumblr.com, you would have seen many hilarious screen captures and other interesting bits about the game. Whoa, that was weird.
Just cleared up. The rebel army leader is named Venutolo, or something. Anyway, he likes dwarf handiwork. Try bringing a piece to the guards. I just bet it gets you in.
Oh, okay. So what you mean is we have to go and backtrack to that dwarf guy that we just spoke to, and we couldn't have just done that in the first place. Oh, well. It's not that long of a trip. But yeah, Animal Crossing. I played the DS one, Wild World, and I got burned out on it pretty quickly. I think I quit after a couple weeks. But I'm really digging the new one so far. It's pretty much the same. I'm just trying to pace myself a little better this time. Trying to only play for a couple hours a day and not burn myself out. Because it is pretty repetitive. If you played any of the Animal Crossings, then you know the types of games that they are. It's better to play for a couple hours each day and, you know, experience the new dialogue, experience any special events, and, not spend a huge amount of time fishing and picking fruit and stuff like that. Oops. Because you have the whole year. Everything in the game happens in real time, so you have plenty of time to collect all the money you need to pay Tom Nook off and get your home upgraded to the highest level. But yeah, it is a really charming little game. And if any of you are playing or just want to be on my 3DS friends list in general, I'll put my 3DS friends code in the description, and then you can just give me mine, and we'll add each other. But yeah, that's the only 3DS game I have so far. I bought one, a 3DS, specifically for that game. I got a used one that already had the game installed on it, and got a pretty good deal on it. And it was almost a brand new 3DS, so I felt pretty good about that. Alright, dwarf, what you got for us?
Oh, no! Not you again! Yes, Guy is here again, Jelly Boy! This time, I want a good dwarf trinket!
A trinket? Oh, you mean one of my skilled artisan creations. I'd be happy to give you one. But why do you want one of those?
I need one to secure passage through the mine! Give! Gah.
Take this one, and leave me alone.
This is just what I needed. Bye.
Man, he kind of shifted gears there. I'd be happy to give you one. Just take it and go. I mean, I guess Golly is kind of a jerk, but I wouldn't have said I'd be happy to give you one. Because frankly, I wouldn't. I would be belligerent, and I would feel very put out. I mean, why does Gaul deserve this guy's trinket? Of course, if this was Animal Crossing, they would probably just give it to you just for the hell of it. They're always giving you gifts in that game. I have a kangaroo in my town. By the way, my town is called The Bump, of course. And my name is Duke, so it's kind of a reflection of reality there. But yeah, I have a kangaroo named Walt who gave me a server rack. Like a whole rack of servers. Like, it doesn't specify what kind of server. I guess in my imagination, I can use them for whatever I want. But yeah, it is the best virtual dollhouse I've ever played.
Listen, you weird little freak of nature. I said you can't pass through.
Gaul has a nice dwarf trinket to give to your leader. Go get him. Now, now, now. Bah.
All right, then. Wait right here. The chief wants to see you right away. Get in there.
Oh, that was easy. Nothing suspicious about this setup at all.
Thank you, peasant, for your oh-so-humble gift. By the way, I'm Clavidin Klotsniffer, Lethal Biffle Poopy Woofen Van Vanantio, Kraken-Lichter Ratchetface the 14th, Feudal Lord of Oderberg. But you can call me Lord Venantio.
Gaul is hungry. Does Lord Venantio have something for Gaul to eat? Gah.
Tell me something. You look like a hard worker. Would you like to join our well-fed cause?
I can't join you. I'm on a quest with Mail and Tat.
Oh, that's such a shame. We could have used your help recovering the treasure.
Treasure? Gah!
Yes, you see, we of the Rebel Army are planning a heist of about 3 tons of gold. In fact, there's a strategy meeting taking place very soon. Too bad you can't make it.
Gold makes Mail very happy. Maybe Gaul will surprise her. And Gaul can get some gold too. Rich, rich, rich. Gaul.
Ah, my eager new friend. Right this way. The meeting room is just ahead. We'd better hurry.
Yeah, it looks like a meeting room.
Your lordship, there's no one here. It's a trap! Run, Lord Venantio!
You are so gullible. There's a reward of 3 million gold on your little group's heads. Or, didn't you know that? You can't expect me to let that go now, can you?
Gaul doesn't know what you're talking about.
Oh, don't play coy with Venantio. I know that you are the three that destroyed Bountyville. Muttonhead told me all about you.
Muttonhead is a liar! Lie, lie, lie! Gah.
Your pretty little corpses are going to finance my whole revolution! But I'm getting ahead of myself. Your fate is sealed. All that's left is for you to die. And for posterity's sake, I do hope you die gracefully.
Alright. I should have saved before I came in here, because as you can see, there's no save option once this area starts. This is a boss technically, I guess, and it confused the hell out of me the first time I did it, because I had no idea that you were supposed to attack these little fireball things. I thought that there was something I was missing. But, nope. All you have to do is go through and kill the fireballs. And they can be a little tricky to hit. Their hitboxes are kind of weird. And the reason I brought Gaul out there instead of Tat was because I was running out of ammunition for my staff. But yeah, this is pretty straightforward once you know what to do. The platforms start crumbling, but you should have plenty of time to to kill all of the fireballs. Hopefully it won't matter that I didn't save. We might take a little bit of damage heading back, but the lava, surprisingly, doesn't hurt that much. Alright. Destroy the happy flames of death. It didn't even give me boss music or anything. I feel kind of cheated. And for some reason, destroying the flames reopens the passage. I don't know why. That's just what happens. I think we need to have a few words with that Lord Venuncio fellow. Hey, you.
Hey, you slippery runt! You tricked me!
So, you escaped my happy flames of death, What a clever feat for such a simple mind! Now then, if you know what's good for you, you'll stay where you are. You mustn't come any closer. If you do, it could be extremely detrimental to your health.
But God will not fall for your tricks two times.
It's not like I didn't warn you. I just had this installed. How do you like it? Tell me, were you truly surprised?
Who's he talking to?
Oh, I just kill myself.
I guess God will fall for your tricks twice, but not three times.
Man, that would have been a more effective trap if that little platform wasn't there. Okay, well, that'll about do it for today's episode. Tune in on Friday, hopefully not so late, for the next installment of Popful Mail. I'm Duke of the Bump. I'll see you guys in the bump, hopefully. Bye, all.